Yo, what is good, YouTube? Welcome back to another JC2K video. In today's video, I'm going to be going through things that I think could honestly make 2K24 MyTEAM Season 2 absolutely phenomenal and really improve the mode significantly from Season 1 NBA 2K24 MyTEAM. I actually think Season 1 of MyTEAM was actually quite successful. I think it was a pretty good season. I think there was a lot of great content. I think 2K knocked it out of the park with the grindable content in a lot of ways. There are certain things that I would like to see improved upon, though, when it comes to the content, and certain things that in the game I just think need to be tweaked to make the game a more favorable gaming experience to the community as a whole. There's always going to be things that frustrate people, but I think there are ways 2K can maximize the game and make it more fun for everyone to play. But before we hop into the video, if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Help me push towards the 14,000 subscriber mark on the channel. I upload every single day, and I would really appreciate it if you all do subscribe. Without further ado, let's hop right into it. So, first things first, what I will start off by saying is that I think Season 1 was actually a very, very good season in terms of content. If I load up my actual money spent account, which I haven't spent actually that much money on, I think sometimes people think I've spent a truly lot of money on my team this year. I've really only spent slightly over $200, which is a lot of money. Don't get me twisted, but almost all of that was in the first week of the game. Since then, I've only spent like $60. So I don't think it's that bad. I haven't spent money on the game in almost an entire month now. It's been 3 weeks. So, and I have pretty close to the best team in the game. I don't have KD, but outside of that, I pretty much have everybody else that you could possibly ask for. And I think grindable content has been phenomenal. You have Chris Bosh, Dwayne Wade. The fact that you are guaranteed players from the player market is awesome. I don't like the fact that everything is a lock-in, and I think that's where you could start with Season 2, is not make every single top player a lock-in. For example, Kevin Durant, even if he was, I don't know how much it costs, it's about a million MT to lock in KD right now. If you complete all the agendas, maybe a little bit less. Let's say KD was 750,000 MT in the player market, or you could lock him in. Although I guess people wouldn't lock him in if it's 750K in the player market. But let's say that KD was 750K. I'd be okay with that. That's really, really, really damn expensive. But you have to remember, other cards are too, and then you could at least sell him back and get some of your MT back. Now, the auction house tax is another huge issue that I have with this game, and I'm not a fan of it at all. But to be honest, I've talked about the auction house tax a lot. I'm not sure it's going to get changed or not. Either way, I'm going to make the best of this game as a whole this year, whether the auction house tax gets tweaked or not. I would love it to, but I don't think it will. KD being auctionable, well, not auctionable is the right term, but buyable in the player market would be very, very good in my opinion. I think the lock-ins are over the top. I don't mind one or two lock-ins a season. This season, we had damn near double-digit legitimately good lock-ins that people wanted to lock in, and people are just forced to choose between, but also just to lose all of their MT if they lock in those cards. Like, that's why I passed on KD's, because I would be locking in so much MT that I could never get any of it back. I locked in Kawhi, but that's the only perfect build set that I locked in, and I did that with MT that I'd already earned. I mean, I didn't do that by spending any sort of money on the game. I think grindable content has been incredible. I just wish there were less lock-ins. That's number one. Season 2, top cards do not need to be gated behind lock-ins. That'd be number one. Number two, while I do think the amount of MT you earn from playing the game is actually very good, I would like to see the MT caps on certain game modes removed. So if you have a really well-graded squad or whatever, and you get more than 5,000 MT in online mode or whatever, you actually get that MT. So if you hit a MT cap, you get all of the MT that you get, and you don't get capped. I think that'd be good. Additionally, I would love to see the actual round rewards, mode rewards, improve significantly. If you look at my account, if you just look at all these unlimited rewards, they're bad, man. I have no incentive to finish unlimited. I'm at 17,000 points right now, 3,000 points away, and I may or may not finish it this week. It depends on how much unlimited I play for fun or not, if I actually wind up wanting to load up the game and play unlimited. If not, I probably won't get this box, but there's no incentive for me to, because it's unsellable. So best case scenario, I pull like a ruby or an amethyst that I already have, and I make like 40k MT, but the odds of that happening are honestly pretty low. But also, the cards in this pack are not valuable. They're all unsellable. We need sellable boxes, number one, so you can maximize the amount of MT you make out of this, because unsellable boxes do not give you any sort of MT. We need sellable boxes. Additionally, we need better rewards. Well, the rewards for unlimited just are not that good this season. Besides the 6 Hall of Fame badges, it's packs. There's 5, 20,000 MT, 35,000 MT. Okay, so it's total 60,000 MT from unlimited for how many games you have to play to maximize the amount of MT. Let's just say you wanted to get all 3 of the Hall of Fame badges. You have to play like 12,000 points, which is going to be something along the lines of 50 or 60 games. At least probably 60 plus games. Whatever the case may be, it's going to be a lot of games to attempt to get a card like or to get all of the good rewards. And even then, the rewards are not that good. That's the thing, the quote unquote good rewards. They're not good. There's not a great grand prize reward. The player rewards really were not that good this season either. I mean, Julius Randle was okay. Alonzo Mourning is decent. And Bruce Bowen's actually quite good, especially at the three, like a really good 3 and D card. I think he's actually very solid. But overall, the mode rewards are really not that great this season. I mean, Oladipo as a salary cap final reward was honestly quite solid. I'm glad 2K moved him to point guard. That was a W. Good job by them because it made him a lot more viable as a card. He's still not a best point guard in the game. Still not top three right now, but he's a viable option at the point guard position, which makes him a good free reward. But I think the player rewards need to be better, number one, and I think the mode rewards, the stuff that's not just player rewards, need to be better. We need to be more rewarded for completing a mode, especially a mode that's as challenging as Unlimited. For 20,000 points, I should not be getting a 10-pack unsellable box of packs from the first day of the game. That's just not rewarding. I don't think it's worth it for anybody, and that is something that I would love to see improved in Season 2. And again, the mode rewards. I just barely touched on it, but I think we really need to see better mode rewards. There should be at least two or three Unlimited rewards on day one of the season that make the best squad in the game, in my opinion. I feel like, and there should be multiple cards that are going to be top cards at their position, at least like top five cards at their position for a while. You shouldn't be literally designated to only being able to get a top free player from grinding level 40 or ultimate rewards from the basic season rewards. Now, I will say 2K, like I said, has done a great job with other free grindable content this season with a lot of the rubies and stuff that they did early in the season with the same face, new place, and summer standouts cards. And then they did this, the fast break card for Clyde. And then now you have a grind for Draymond. There was a grind for the Draymond. There's also Clyde, of course. Then there's D Wade and Dominique Wilkins and Chris Bosh for the small percentage of people that can get him, but still a free grind as well, even if it is for less people. I still love it. I think they did a very good job with dropping a lot of good free grindable content this season. And I certainly hope that continues. Like I said, I think they knocked the content out of the park in a lot of ways, but mode rewards need to be better because people aren't incentivized to play these modes. They're just not right now, to be honest. The only reason people would play the modes is to get Brandon Roy, and then they play to get the player reward, and they don't have any interest in playing the reward. Like, Unlimited's my favorite game mode, but I'm just not that incentivized to play the game right now. I don't feel it urging in me. Whereas if this was a good reward, I would have already gotten it at this point. Like, I would be grinding Unlimited. It would make me want to stream more, make me want to play the game more if there was more to grind for, but there's simply not right now. There's no competitive tournament. I'm crossing my fingers and praying there's going to be some sort of competitive tournament after the $1 million planout tournament, like a later in the year comp my team tournament, because I find it hard to believe 2K is literally going to go a whole year without anything competitive for my team at all, but I think it is possible. I mean, after the fiasco that was last year, both by 2K's part and by our part, I wouldn't be totally shocked, but I'm crossing my fingers and hoping that comes later this year. But I don't think it's realistic to expect any sort of competitive My Team tournament from 2K, at least until that playdown tourney is over. So I think you got to have more to play for. I mean, there's got to be more to play for. Some more competitive type agendas like the gauntlet stuff would be cool. Even if it was for something like a coach, that would be pretty sick. Or whatever the case may be. Even just like smaller rewards. It doesn't have to be players. MT rewards for winning a certain number of games in a row or whatever the case may be in different modes. Like, there could be different things that could drop on a weekly basis that would entice people to play the game more and give them more of a reason to play it. It doesn't have to all be offline stuff, because for people like me who like to sweat online, I just don't feel that incentivized most of the time to do it right now, especially when the mode rewards simply are not very good. I mean, I will probably not get close to completing Unlimited in Season 2, to be completely honest, if there is not a good, seriously good Unlimited reward. I'm just not going to be very incentivized to complete the mode. Like, I played F8 82 games so far this season. I'll probably get close to 90 by the end of the season with this week finishing up, but I don't think I will get close to that next season. I'll probably play 30 or 40 total. It would be my guess if there's no incentive to play the mode. And this is generally my favorite mode to play, but it's just, if there's no reason to play, I'm probably not going to load up just to play the game every single day when I already play it for videos and stuff. So I don't know. I think there are certain ways that 2K can certainly make the game better for Season 2, and then I think they also deserve their props in a lot of ways for what they have done in Season 1 that has made it a successful season. Level 40 and the ultimate reward need to stay good. I have not mentioned those. I expect that they probably will stay good, but they need to stay good, especially the ultimate reward. Well, really both of them, because they're both free. The level 40, I expect, will be a good card regardless, because that level 40 card is something that is a paywall you can buy your way to. Brandon Roy is not a card that you can buy your way to. The Season 1 Unlimited reward was a card you had to, or ultimate reward was a card you had to grind to. And really, Brandon Roy is one of the very few cards in the game that is truly rewarding to have earned and grinded for, because he is probably the best player in his game, in the game at his position, and he was a truly challenging grind. So it was rewarding, in my opinion, to get a card like Brandon Roy. I want to see both of those rewards remain good. I expect the level 40 will to entice people to spend money on the game and level up quickly, which, again, it will probably work for a lot of people, including potentially me, if it's a great level 40. But the ultimate reward needs to remain good as well to continue to incentivize people to play the game. Because if it's not, they're just not going to play the game that much, which is not what you want, honestly, as a player base, because there's no really main motivation to play. Like, people in the past played towards 250 to try to get better at the game and stuff. That was a motivation for a lot of people to play the game. And this year, that's not there. And I don't know. I feel like we need a little bit more incentive sometimes, considering the rewards are not as good as they need to be. But that's probably the biggest complaint that I have right now with what they can improve upon, at least in Season 2. Hoping to see some really good rewards and some things change, hopefully. Would love to see a couple tweaks with the in-game mechanics and certain things as well, like the auction house tax and stuff. But regardless, I will give 2K. I think Season 1 was a success. I'd give it a 7 out of 10, 8 out of 10, something like that. Like, it was a decent season. Pretty good job. Hoping to see Season 2 be a continuation of Season 1 and build upon and improve and not regress. I'll be really disappointed if we regress in Season 2 and stop getting nearly as consistent content. The communication goes away. The grindable stuff goes away. If that happens, I'm going to be really, really disappointed. But we'll see. Fingers crossed 2K comes through, but I don't have that much hope. I guess we'll see. But hopefully y'all did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. I'll be back with more 2K content very, very soon. I appreciate y'all. Peace.